It is so much place here, you can come nearer if you want. So much place is here, so you can sit.
अज्ञानतिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः वंचाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो महाबदन्नाय कृष्णप्रेमप्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्यनाम्ने गौरत्रिषु गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकायै तदालये कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तदभक्ताय नमो संकर्षणः कारणतोयसायि गर्भोदसायि च पयोदिशायि शेषस्य जस्यांशकलासनित्यानन्दाक्षरामः शरणम्
Today we are going to celebrate very auspicious birthday of Param Pujyapad Nitya Lila Pravishtung Vishnupad Sri Srimad Bhakti Rakshak Sridhar Swami, Sridhar Maharaj. The month is Kartik, and I told that how sacred this month is. All the beautiful pastimes of Krishna took place in this month. Maharaj, also binding of Damodar Leela here, Radha Damodar Leela in this month, Kansa was killed in this month, so many. Krishna used to graze his cow. First began in Gopashtami. Yesterday, you know that it was Bahulashtami at Radha Kunda. All have gone to take bath. That is the beginning of Radha Kunda, beginning day of Radha Kunda, prakat of Radha Kunda also. Appearance of Radha Kund also in this very month yesterday. So many pastimes of Krishna took place in this month. As a drishtikon,
angle of vision,
we see that. Also Vaishnav, our Gurudev, disappeared in the first day of this Sarat Purnima. We see that Swami Maharaj, disappearance day, in this very month.
He appeared and disappeared in this month, Swami Maharaj.
Appeared not. Appeared in Bhadra Mas. Bhadra. Also, Narottam Thakur, this appearance day, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, so many Vaishnavas in this month, appearing and disappearing day. Now you are lucky today to celebrate the appearance day. Aparam Pujyapad Nitya Lila Pravishta Ong Vishnu Upad Shishamad Bhakti Rakshak Sridhar Maharaj. I know that some of the disciples of Pujyapad Sridhar Maharaj are here. I know that he is our Shiksha Guru also, myself, Devikam Maharaj, Shiksha Guru. He gave sannyas to our Gurudev. And there are so many senior Vaishnava also here. So I think that it will be proper to give them chance to to offer their heartly Pushpanjali, glorifying him, and they should try to do. I think that what's name? Urukam Prabhu, aap unhi ke shishya the. But gotcha. And you yourself? Sridhara Maharaj. Then yes, I know that. Also Brinda Devi, Champaklata, also the mother of Madhavi, so many. Yes, yes, Yashoda also, Maya Yashoda, and other Sova. So I request first Sri, what name? Ramananda Brajavasi, to glorify him and give your Pushpanjali. You can stand up and come here. Oh, are Panda ji, koi asan leo. Hey, jaldi se ek chair leo. Bring a chair at once. Are jaldi ek chair leo. तब तक यहाँ पर बैठी आई अरे नीचे अरे सम्मान करने से हमारा हमारे गुरु जी ने आप लोगों का सम्मान किया है जल्दी ले आओ कहाँ कोई अच्छी चेयर नहीं बड़ी वाली जल्दी जल्दी लाओ एक आसन दो तो इस पर यानी आसन जल्दी जल्दी करो You should bring a garland, new garland. Have you made? Kahan gaya? Oh, wait a little. Sit down there. Give me that and mic also. माइक नवीन अरे वेरी नवीन नवीन ऑलवेज एब्सेंट वेर ही इज गो हैज गॉन ए एक तो नवीन के डाक्टर तुम কখনো এখানে থাকবে না যখনই কাজ হবে তোমার ওই দিকে কাজ তোমার নানা প্রকারে কাজ লেগে যায়
যাত্রা হে মহারাজ
কতরুক মে তোমার কাজ বলি যে আমার সঙ্গে এখানে থাক আরে ইধর আও ঘর মে বেঠ এক আচ্ছা আচ্ছা কপড়া লাও 400 রুপিয়ে লে 400 জলদি আর কুছ ফল লে আনা হি জবর जमुना प्रसाद चतुर्वेदी बड़े चौबे जी ग्रेट चौबे जी हे जबर पंडा जी ऑफ मथुरा हि सो मच क्वालिफाइड हि इज नॉट लाइक अदर चौबे जी क्वारलिंग एब्यूजिंग अदर्स हिज फादर वॉज वन ऑफ दी learned person of Mathura Chaturvedi and he was so polite and both he gentle he was so gentle person he never wanted anything from any disciple or anyone he used to help us in traveling all Parikrima with us. I never wanted a single pice. And the same qualities in him. He always helps in all matter. Not only doing parikrama or anything, but when we need any help, He helps us. You are saying that He is going and giving direction where to go, always with us. Day and night, when we will call, He is with us. So gentle. So I want to honor Him because He has directed us in so many Mathura's important places. So on behalf of you all, I want to honor Him. Our honor is your all honor. I'm requesting Him also on all of behalf that today He should take our nimantan for serving prasadam also. Now you can stand up and speak.
Dear Guru Maharaj, on this most sacred day of your blessed appearance in this world, I shall try to offer, however awkwardly and insufficiently, some words in praise of your inexhaustible glories by recounting some of the innumerable gifts which you have so graciously bestowed upon the world.
You are all hearing?
Yes.
Which you have so graciously bestowed upon the world, which was thus transformed by the touch of your lotus feet. What first comes to mind is how, by your teaching of don't try to change the environment, change yourself, you so mercifully freed us from vainly struggling and quarreling with the world around us. You informed us that we should not waste our valuable time and energy in trying to oppose the environment, that there were in fact no enemies in the environment, that our own ego was the only enemy who needed to be subdued, the only corrupt estate manager who needed to be discharged from his post. You made a positive eyewitness identification of that shameless thief known as our own materially conditioned mind, who is stealing the inherent wealth of the innocent, childlike spirit soul. And thus you gave us the opportunity to reclaim the rightful inheritance of our divine conception in the plane of absolute goodness. And you granted us the privilege of utilizing every atom of our existence in the service of the Absolute Center. You continuously guided us in cultivating the understanding that every aspect of the environment was actually friendly to us, and that it was simply a matter of readjusting our own angle of vision. Naturally, it was also you who then graciously bestowed the ability to read the environment correctly. By your most happy instruction to dive deep into reality, you compassionately released us from the powerful grip of the tendency to perform rituals blindly and mechanically without understanding the deeper significance underlying them. You most lovingly encouraged us to search for the meaningful essence within the rituals, the purpose behind them, and the sublime prospect beyond them. You advised us to always take the middle path in this approach, just as Lord Krishna advised Arjuna in the Gita, to avoid the extremes and never artificially embrace or reject anything at face value, but rather even-mindedly and open-heartedly evaluate the merit of a thing without the slightest trace of prejudice, by measuring its distance from the conceptions given in the Bhagavatam and by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Naturally, it was also you who provided the measuring stick of spiritual common sense and discrimination, and thus protected us from the pitfall of thoughtlessly accepting or condemning anyone or anything on the basis of superficial or provincial considerations. You repeatedly urged us to understand how everything is coming from the absolute good, our affectionate guardians, and how everything had its positive utility in the service of the sweet absolute. Then it was you who bestowed the ability to find the good in everyone and everything, and thus engage everything in the service of the Lord accordingly, with honesty, integrity, and intelligence, completely devoid of any ulterior motive or separate interest, into the spiritual domain of the Lord's enchantingly beautiful and dynamically flowing pastimes. You reminded us that the path of spiritual progress was not below our feet, but rather above our heads, and that those who abandon the heavy burden of pride, resulting from overconfidence in personal ability and over-reliance on exclusive self-effort, and who genuinely adopted a mood of desperately requiring the grace of those above us, they would alone be granted admission into the plane of infinite mercy, all-embracing love and absolute harmony, without the least obstruction. Although the enumeration of your divine gifts cannot possibly be completed, either here and now or at any other time, Guru Maharaj, at least one more gift must be mentioned, and that is your supremely generous benediction of being always present in the hearts of your sincere followers. You are ever the joyous source of our brightest moments and our unfailing solace in our darkest hours. We have come to realize that our own pockets are truly empty, and that your causeless mercy is the indispensably vital nourishment upon which we are dependent for our whole life's maintenance and spiritual prospect. Therefore, on this day, we pray for the strength to rededicate ourselves to your lotus feet, remembering one of your favorite quotes from Longfellow, as we continue along our journey towards the land of dedication, the plane of inconceivable beauty and sweetness. Quote, "Trust no future, however pleasant. Let the dead past bury its dead. Act, act in the living present, heart within and God over in." Unquote. Your meaning serpent, Ramadan.
I took initiation from Nityalila Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj in 72, and then after he left the planet in 77, I found myself in a void. I was doing service in Haridaspur, and I did service there from 1976 to 1981. And then in 81, I took shelter at Srila Bhakti Raka Keshita, Swami Maharaj, my beloved Shishikuri. There's an understanding what Shiksha Guru is a very difficult topic. When I was Srila Prabhupada in 1977, the sannyasi I was residing at in Haridaspur, he had written a letter to Swami Maharaj asking about what our this parampara meant. He mentioned that this was Bhagavad Shiksha Parampara. And is it true that in Bhagavad Gita, all these quotes, Prabhupada wrote back at that time and he said that we should not discuss these points at this moment. So it was put on hold. I discussed these points at the sannyasi and haridas forum for many years after Prabhupada left the planet. So in when we chant the Panchatattva mantra, Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhupada Nisi and Vaita Gadadhar, Swasati Gaur, Pampatavinda. We aware of the Panchatattva mantra. But sometimes we forget what this Adi means. Adi actually refers to the sixth tattva, Chaitattva. Chaitanya Chaitanya, the sixth tattva has to refer to Guru tattva. So it was Guru Tattva, to actually come to the full realization of what Guru Tattva means, we have to understand what Parinama Guru, Mantra Guru, and Shiksha Guru is. Shiksha Guru can be many, unlimited Shiksha Gurus. And this is very merciful, because once your Guru leaves the planet, then you find your heart very much in a void. And the only way to relieve this, actually this void, this viraha, this human separation, is to take shelter of Shiksha Guru. Bhaktivinoda Thakura states in Tattva-Vivek that as long as we don't come to a self-realized platform, we should continue taking shelter of Shiksha Guru. This is a process. So this understanding of Shiksha Guru is very, it's a very subtle point because after Swami Maharaj, Prabhupada left the planet, and I went to Srila Sridhara Maharaj ashram, immediately there was people saying, oh, Srila Maharaj is Prabhupada Shiksha Guru, and he is higher than Prabhupada, etc. like that. This is very dangerous. Because when you're comparing Vaishnavas, these are, Srila Sridhara Maharaj remarked, these are very, very subtle points. Be careful when we're comparing Vaishnavas. It's said that even Brahma was our original guru, and he himself was put into the wilderness. And the Leela, Brahma Vimohan Leela, Mohan Leela, Brahma himself, our original guru, was put into the wilderness. And then after he realized his fault, he didn't get much penance and austerities, from Navaridhamma, so in Antarji Mayapur. And then he took birth as Haridas Thakur. And when he appeared as Haridas Thakur, he got the association of Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu called him Namacharya, Haridas Thakur, for very, very good reason. Not only simply because he chanted 22 and a half hours a day, but because Haridas Thakur was a personification of humility. From Lord Brahma, the highest post, he took birth as Haridas Thakur in a Muslim family. So we can relate that to that point coming from west, having western bodies. I'm very much attached and close to Haridas Thakur, and I had the fortune to serve Haridas Thakur. In this verse, he reasons ill who say that Vaishnavas die with thou art living still and sound. The Vaishnavas die to live, and living still, spread the whole name around. Srila Sridhara Maharaj, in this one verse, which is very famous, he extracted the phrase, die to live. This actually is the epitome, the summary of our whole Vaishnava philosophy, die to live. We completely die on the material plane, we give up all our material desires, and we take shelter, sharanagati, ananya sharanagati, complete surrender. This This is the point we want to reach, complete surrender. So seeing also that Srila Maharaja's, one of his favorite books was this book by Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Sharanagati. Sharanagati means unconditional surrender. And the first song in this book was Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Jivindaya Koya Swapasad Swapasad Sadhava Saha Avatari. And this, those are, there's many, many nice verses in Mona Gurubhati, like this, the Sharanagati. It said that Srila Sridhara Maharaja took this book himself, had it printed, and he distributed it freely, Sharanagati. And then he also wrote a book taken from Sharanagati called Tapana Jivanamrita, which summarized all the aspects of Sharanagati. Dhamya Abhinivedana, Gopti Pevaran, Vacharati Pe Krishna, Vishvasa Palan, Bhakti Anukula Bhakti Kajir Sikar, Bhakti Kajir Kumar. All these different six aspects like that of Sharanagati. And he took all the different scriptures, Bhagavatam, different acharyas, and he grouped this up into Sharanagati. It's a beautiful book. And I know, and many of my godbrothers know that Srila Sridhara Maharaja Prabhupada, my Guru Maharaj, my Mother Guru, published this book. And he also wanted to publish Bhagavad Gita. So we were very close. So the thing is like, the point is that I was trying to think about in comparing Vaishnavas, we should be very careful that even though Brahma and Haridas Thakur took birth as Haridas Thakur, Haridas Thakur was in Dasiras, and we know that Rupa Goswami was Rupa Manjari, and he is in higher Ras. The only way we can realize this is through the teachings of in the words of the Vaishnava, the Kuta Vaishnava. Therefore, in that first verse of Sharanagati, Bhakti Thakur is saying, Kandiya Kandiya, Bolyami Tua Dham, Shikaya Sharanagati, Kurahim Dham. He's praying, he's weeping. And I'm so fallen, my condition is so fallen. Please, you just teach me this way of unconditional surrender, the Sharanagati. Make me Uttam. Only with Uttam can all these teachings coming from our Shiksha line be revealed to us. So, there's many other deep, sacred things that Srila Sridhara Maharaja gave to us. But this understanding of Guru Tantra was, he gave a very solid foundation to all of the devotees that came in his presence. And I, for one, feel very, very fortunate that I got to sit at his lotus feet and exchange some conversation, asking some subtle points. Even such a great kavi, such a great Vaishnava poet as Srila Sridhara Maharaja, like this Sujanaranda Radhika Padarikam, Jigadaranadarantara Patsarvam, Varadavoyadaya, Ujapadam, Padamami Siddha Prabhupadam. It's such an elegant, beautiful poem. When I came in the presence of Srila Sridhara Maharaja, I asked him about this poem. And he laughed and said that this poem, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta says that Prabhupada appreciated this poem very much. And he wrote it in happy style, very happy style. It was almost like a dance. It's a circle. And if we study the poem, it circles like this, just like a dance. But then he said to me, he said, but my Guru Maharaj, Srila Prabhupada told me, you cannot just sit down and write like that. So in it, I know he wrote a very beautiful Paramadhamma Stotra, which was appreciated so highly by Srila Krishnadas Babaji Maharaj. We sang this verse, one verse from this Paramadhamma Deva Stotra. He is such an incredible poet, but what made such an incredible Vaishnava poor was not just his understanding of Siddhanta and ontology, but his humility, his dunya. As we could see, these Vaishnavas, they're so humble, they melt our hearts. And at every moment we should be taking shelter of them.
Sridhara Maharaj
at that time was residing at his mat in Navadvip Dham, and I asked one of my godbrothers, have you ever gone there? Have you ever met him? And he told me, yes, I've gone there. I go there sometimes, but don't tell anyone. Even at that time, this was being kept somewhat secret. So I said, well, I want to go and meet with him. So one evening we went there. And my goal, because I was fortunate to be in the personal presence of our Srila Swami Maharaj Prabhupada, on quite a number of occasions through the years, I had the opportunity to feel what it was like to be in this divine presence. And I was very curious as to how this experience would be to be in the presence of another very exalted Vaishnava, Paramahansa Vaishnava. And when we came there, Sridhara Maharaja at that time was not well. He was lying flat on his bed late in the evening, 8 p.m. It was very dark, and we went to the rooftop where he resided and knelt down at his bedside. Then I was introduced by this devotee. And immediately he began to speak the most beautiful Harikatha, the most beautiful description of the sweetness of Krishna's transcendental names, quoting so many different slokas from Rupa Goswami and so many different shastras. And this went on 10, 15 minutes, and I was just like drowning in this nectar of Harikatha. This was my first experience meeting him. And then we left, and I wanted to come again to have his sangha. And another day I came in the morning and had some exchange. And every time that I would meet with him, I met with him on 3 occasions in that year, he was always the most kind-hearted, most merciful, always giving so much concern and so much love and giving the most wonderful explanations of the Shastra that I'd never heard. So much depth he was giving. Then, on the final day when I met with him, he had spoken with us. And at that time, there was also some restriction being placed on devotees coming to see him, which later on, of course, became a very wide gulf between the Western Iskcon society at that time and him. But even in 1979, this was beginning to take place. So he told me, he said, once I was sitting with your Gurudev, meaning our Swami Maharaj, once I was sitting with him, and I was lamenting to him, because Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur had also requested Sridhara Maharaj earlier to go to the Western countries. And at that time, Srila Sridhara Maharaj did not, he agreed, yes, I can go, but I do not feel myself that I am able to understand the intonation of the Westerner's speech. He mentioned like this. But if you order, I will go. Then Srila Bhaktisiddhanta ordered another godmother to go. But he was sitting with our Gurudev, and he was expressing to him, saying that I'm feeling very sad that I could not go to carry out this order of Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati. He was lamenting in this way. And he was telling me this. And then he said, and your Gurudev, he told me, he said, that is all right. I will travel all over the world and I'll bring all my disciples to you. You can train them up to go back to Godhead. And then at that moment he leaned forward and he looked at me sitting very close to him, and he said, so why they have made this restriction? His very soft Vaishnava heart was actually hurt by this, because he had been requested by Srila Prabhupada, he had been requested by Srila Bhaktisiddhanta, and his beloved lordships, Sri Sri Radha Govinda Sundarji, this was his divine duty to perform, and here was this obstruction coming. So at that time, I could not answer, and then later on so many things happened. But what Sridhara Maharaj gave to us Western devotees is a vast ocean of transcendental knowledge.
clearly a vast ocean. There are so many conversations which took place between 1980 and the time when he passed away in 1988. And many books have come out so far, and many more will come out in the future. And what he gave to the Western world in the English language was utterly unique. Even one of his godbrothers, still living today, Parikrima Puri Maharaj, has remarked that what Sridhara Maharaj spoke in the English language, he never even gave in the Bengali language before. And what he spoke in English should be translated into Bengali and distributed to Bengali. Such was the depth and the level of the Siddhanta that he gave. So I could speak so many things in glorification of Sridhara Maharaj. Today we're all gathered here and everyone can have opportunity, but I wanted to just read one page from this Vyasapuja book of Sridhara Maharaj, which has just been published, which is actually spoken by our Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. And this was spoken in 1974 in his presence, when there were many other disciples present. He was actually introducing him to his disciples who had never met him before. We are very fortunate to hear His Divine Grace, Om Vishnupad Paramahansa Parivrajakacharya Bhakti Rakshak Sridhara Maharaj. By age and by experience, in both ways, he is senior to me. I was fortunate to have his association since a long time, since perhaps 1930. At that time, he had not accepted sannyas, but had just left home. He went to preach in Allahabad, and on that auspicious occasion, we were connected. Sridhara Maharaj lived in my house for many, many years, so naturally, we had very intimate talks. He has such high realizations of Krishna that one would faint to hear them. He was always my good advisor, and I took his advice seriously, because from the very beginning, I knew that he was a pure devotee of Krishna. So I wanted to associate with him. Krishna and our Prabhupada, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta, liked him to prepare me. Our relationship was very intimate. After the breakdown of our spiritual master's institution, I wanted to organize another institution, making Sridhara Maharaj the head. Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur told me that Sridhara Maharaj is one of the finest preachers of Krishna consciousness in the world. So I wanted to take him everywhere. This was my earnest desire. But since he could not go around the world and preach, at least the people of the world should come to hear from him. For spiritual advancement of life, we must go to someone who is actually practicing spiritual life. So, if one is actually serious to take instructions from a Shiksha Guru or instructing spiritual master, I can refer him to one who is the most highly competent of all my godbrothers. This is B.R. Sridhara Maharaj. I consider Sridhara Maharaj to be even my Shiksha Guru. So what to speak of the benefit that others can have from this association? So, at the time of our passing of our Guru Dev, he mentioned to us that if we had questions in the future, there were two personalities that we could approach. He mentioned the name of Srila Bhakti Rakshak Sridhara Maharaj, and he mentioned the name of our divine Guru Dev, Srila Bhaktivedanta. So our spiritual lives will be healthy and will thrive, inasmuch as we go to the lotus feet of exalted Paramahansa Vaishnavas and fully surrender at their lotus feet and serve them, as Rupa Goswami has stated, Shushrushaya Vajana Vigyam Ananyam Anya Nindadi Shunyam Vrida Ipsita Sangalabdhya. This is how we deal with Uttam Bhagwats. Unfortunately, in the present day, there is a very great difficulty amongst many of the Western world to understand who is a Uttam Bhagwat and how to deal with him. If that problem can simply be solved, then this Krishna consciousness movement will go on in a healthy way throughout the world, just as it was going on during the time of our beloved Guru Maharaj, the Prabhupada Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj. So all of us who are present here are most fortunate because we are actually situated at the lotus feet of a very great Vaishnava who is also Snigdha, who is very affectionate, and who is giving his heart and soul also to carry out the order of his Sikha Guru, Srila A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj. So on this occasion, I offer my humble Dandava Pranams to the lotus feet of my beloved Sikha Guru Dev, Srila Bhaktivedanta Narayan Maharaj, and to all of his godbrothers, and to all of the Vaishnavas present, and I beg for your mercy that I may continue serving their lotus feet.
Although I am not qualified to speak in the presence of all these wonderful Vaishnavas and our exalted Shri Gurudev, Shri Sridhara Maharaj, I have been requested to say some things, so please don't take any offense if I say anything wrong. If I say anything which is helpful, please remember that. When I have never personally met Srila Sridhara Maharaj, also never met Srila A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj personally, but I have read their books and I have been in the association of their followers who are present here today, and I think this is a wonderful occasion that we are here today celebrating the appearance of Srila Bhakti Rakshak Sinadev Goswami Maharaj. This is the proper way to honor and celebrate the presence of great, great souls who are just coming here in this world to give us their mercy, their blessings, so that we may become attracted to real, pure bhakti, real spiritual life. To celebrate it in this way is the most proper way to give respect to all great Vaishnavas like we are doing here today is a great fortune. This will help us so much to continue in our progress towards pure bhakti. So I will not take too much of your time, but I will try to share something which I remember when I think about Srila Sridhara Maharaj. And that thing which I remember and which strikes me very much is his teaching how in order to make progress we have to always be ready to go and leave behind that thing which we may have understood. We have to always be ready to embrace the higher principle, and in order to do that we should be ready to leave behind that thing which we may have understood to be the highest principle yesterday. Even Srila A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, if I recall properly, he used to say, this Krishna consciousness program is so nice, it gives us so much happiness. But if today I will meet something which is better, which will make me more happy, at once I will embrace that thing. So this is the way which I personally have understood how we should look towards spiritual life. We should always look how to increase our own happiness. Meaning that what will really make us happy? That thing which will make us happy is if we can please Sri Krishna and his dear associates, our beloved guides, our beloved Shiksha Gurus, our beloved venerable Vaishnavas, who we are so fortunate to be associated with. To give them pleasure, that will really make our hearts so happy. So Srila Sridhara Maharaj, he has kindly given us so many wonderful instructions and by his personal example teaching us how to look always to increase our pure bhakti. Another thing which I remember, how on the path of bhakti, the only way to make progress is to be in the association of stalwart devotees. Yeah. Unless we are, Srila Maharaj explains, if we want to make progress on the path towards that final goal, the sweet, wonderful realm of Raja Bhakti, we should take advantage of the stalwart Vaishnavas who are there. Without their help, we will simply stumble and fall and not be able to make any progress. So I feel very much grateful that His Divine Grace Bhakti Raksha Srila Maharaj has been so kind to leave us so many wonderful teachings. And not only that, that He is part of our family of Gaudiya Vaishnavas. Yeah, the families which we are in at present today, and the wonderful Vaishnavas who we are associating with today, Srila Bhaktivedanta Goswami Narayan Maharaj, my beloved Diksha and Siksha Guru, Srila Bhaktivedanta Goswami Maharaj, Tridikra Maharaj, yeah, who are present here today. So I will not take more of your time. Thank you for allowing me to glory Bhashka Bhakti Rakshar Sigali Goswami Maharaj Ki.
I'm very unqualified to speak anything, Srila Maharaj. I was unprepared for this. So I'll just speak something that comes to my heart. After this appearance on my Reverend Srila Pundit Srila Prabhupada, there was a vacuum, an emptiness. Somehow, by the grace of some sannyasi godbrothers of mine, they introduced me to Srila Maharaj. And the same feeling in the heart that came in the presence of Srila Prabhupada, knowing you can give your heart, your life, your very soul, such a personality, the same feeling was there with Srila Maharaj. Srila Prabhupada and Srila Maharaj were very close. And if you would read some of Srila Maharaj's books, his writings are so profound. One line leads to another, like rivers of nectar. I was taken back so deeply by his sweet words. Prabhu said before, die to live. He quoted Hegel, German philosopher, very much. One statement he said that I always thought was very, very sweet was, mercy was beyond justice, love was beyond power. Very, very deep meanings, very sweet. Once, Srila Maharaj was sitting on his bed, and some devotees came to him. They said, oh Maharaj, we've heard some devotees that made aparad against Vaishnava. And he sat up very quickly and said, who is this Vaishnava they have offended? So we're sorry to tell you, but they have made offense against you. And he went back and said, I am not a Vaishnava. So now there are many books in English, more being produced, that we can take advantage of. And that same feeling, that same river of nectar that flows in one's heart when you read his books, now coming from Srila Bhaktivedanta Narayana Maharaj, that same feeling that I had in my heart when I first came upon Srila Prabhupada and Srila Maharaj, the same feeling as with our beloved master, Srila Bhaktivinoda Narayan Maharaj. Another episode, I just might want to say, Srila Maharaj wore thick glasses. He really could see so well in front of him. So one time, a devotee came to him. Srila Maharaj put his hands in front of his eyes and his glasses, took his glasses off. There was no difference. In 1977, Srila Prabhupada was talking to Srila Maharaj. He says, please come, we'll make you a room in Mayapur, and I will make an elevator so you don't have to walk. Because Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur told Srila Prabhupada, you bring him out with you someday. And Srila Prabhupada, to the very last, wanted to fulfill that instruction. So, many of you have not met Srila Maharaj. You can meet him through his books to one degree. But that same flavor, that same wonderful Krishna consciousness that he gave to the world, you can now receive in a very beautiful way, a very sweet vibe by Srila Bhaktivinoda Narayan Maharaj. So I request all of you to help me in my path, my progress, to surrender and give the world Srila Narayan Maharaj.
He came with Prabhupada to do Parikrima, Vraj Mandal Parikrima. And after this, in 1944, he came with so many Vaishnavas of Gaudiya Math. At that time, he has written something about our pandas, his father at that time was there, and he has written one shloka of 4 lines about him, and his beautiful signature is there. of Pujyapad Bhakti Rakshak Sridhara Maharaja. I request him, Pandaji, to read that four lines of the slokas and to show his beautiful signature.
Narayana namaskritya naram jaiva narottam devim saraswati asam tadum vasudev sutam devam kanuta chandur vardhanam devaki varmanandam krishnam vande jagat. Maharaj ki aagya hui hai to usko sirudhar karta hua raja hai. मैं हिंदी में ही बोलूंगा, इंग्लिश बूटी बूटी आती है, इस वजह से इंग्लिश में बोलना असंभव था। ये जो है ब्रज 84 कोस के अंतर्गत फैला हुआ है और इसमें आप लोग जो है सभी देश देश अंदर से विदेशों से यात्रा के लिए आए। ऐसा है कि ब्रज जो है 84 कोस का ही क्यों है, ब्रिज जो है यानी ऐसा कहते हैं जो है 84 लाख योनी है, 84 लाख योनियों के पश्चात में ये मनुष्य का देह मिलता है। उस मनुष्य के देह में इस 84 लाख योनियों से निवृत्त होने के कारण यहाँ ब्रिज जो 84 कोस का है इसमें आदमी भ्रमण करता है। दूसरे ये है कि यहाँ पर ऐसा कहते हैं कि 4 महीने को देवता जो है सो जाते हैं, देव सैनी एकादशी से और देव उत्थान एकादशी आ जाएगी उसमें देवता उठते हैं, लेकिन देवता जो है सोते नहीं है। अगर देवता सो जाए तो प्रलय हो जाए। देवता जो है 4 महीने यहाँ ब्रज में निवास करते हैं, सावन अषाढ़ से लेकर के और कार्तिक तक, सावन भादो क्वार और कार्तिक 4 महीना देवता रूप यही निवास करते हैं। इसी से ब्रज 84 कोस की परिक्रमा जो होती है वो इसी महीने में होती है। हमारे पूर्वज उन्हें जो है हमारा संबंध इस मातृ संप्रदाय से करीब 500 वर्ष पहले से है। हमारे पूर्वजों ने रूप सनातन जीव गोस्वामी आज सबके लिए यात्रा कराई थी, उन सबका प्रमाण हमारे पास में मौजूद है। उसके बाद में भक्त सिद्धांत सरस्वती ठाकुर, इनको हमारे बाबा ग्रैंड फादर ने यात्रा कराई थी सन 1932। उसके बाद में श्रीधर महाराज ने यात्रा की, उसमें जो उन्होंने लिखा है उसकी 4 श्लोक वक्त उन्होंने जो है लिखा है उसके मुँह में सुनाता हूँ। श्री श्री वृंदावन चंद्र श्यो पुत्रो गोपाल नाम को मथुरा धाम वास्तव्यो ब्रज तीर्थ पुरोहित। श्री गुरुपाद पद्मश्य गौरियान भय भानु भी श्री श्री भक्त सिद्धांत सरस्वती नमामि। सो अधुना श्रीकृतो अस्मावीर संतो गज चंद्र गई त्रिदंडी श्रीधर चैत सानुवई गौरवार। ये जो है उनकी हस्ताक्षर है। ये भक्त सिद्धांत सरस्वती ठाकुर की हस्ताक्षर है, ये उन्होंने लिखा। ये सब जो है ये उन्होंने जो है हमारा कार्य जो है तो आप लोगों के साथ में घूमने का ही है, तो उसके लिए जो है एक साक्षी रूप में लिखा लीजिए। ये सब जो है जीव गोस्वामी वगैरह और ये हैं उन सबके लेख है यहाँ। हम जो है महाराज आपको जो है इंग्लिश रूपांतर ट्रांसलेशन कर देंगे।
गौड़ीय वैष्णव संप्रदाय सिंस 500 इयर्स बिकॉज रूप सनातन वेयर अबाउट 500 इयर्स बिफोर, सो जी गोस्वामी हैज गिवन सिग्नेचर हियर, सो दे हैव कलेक्टेड सो मेनी सिग्नेचर्स ऑफ ऑल and are all disciplic orders, acharya have given honor to them. So we give honor still. He has very beautiful signature of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur, also our Gurudev, also Sridhara Maharaj. Now I will request Param Pujyapad Srila Bhakti Vedanta Trivikram Maharaj that he will see. Because he has seen him, he is near to me. Our Gurudev, each year he used to go after Navadvip Dham Parikrama with us to Pujyapad Sridhara Maharaj, to honor him. So he knows more than, so many things more better than me. So I am praying him to speak something about him.
Om Agnati Vedanta Saganan Shalapaya Chukshurun Gitam Dina Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha. It is a very difficult task for me to express the highness of Paramapujyapad Srila Sridhara Maharaj, because I live in this world, in the world of Maya, and he is a resident, he is the dweller of Golok. This we have heard. But I do not know what was he exactly by my knowledge. This much I know, that he was a favorite disciple of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur. And also, my Gurudev accepted sannyas from him and started preaching after the demise of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur in the company with him. My Gurudev was tried to take him with his company, but I don't know why, what is the cause. He got him separated and started another institution. However, there it is difficult to understand this sort of differences, whether it is adjustable or not. Everyone wants to regard his Gurudev most high and thinks he is at the top. And everyone tries to deal with him like this. And with other. But I am told that Guru Tattva is one. And is manifested in various shapes and figures. Diversity and unity is a thing which is not imagined by the souls by the who are engrossed by Maya. Therefore, there may be some exaggeration and overestimation in the speech of the bound soul. But exaggeration is not admirable, and defaming is also not admirable. So it is very difficult task to express the spiritual master. One cannot understand properly his situation. But we know that they are gracious upon all, and by their grace we may reach transcendental. I do not wish to speak any more about this. Let us hear from Mr. Parikrima Maharaj. Thank you.
चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः मञ्चाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमः नमो महाबदन्याय कृष्णप्रेमप्रदाय कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्यनाम्ने गौरप्रतिशे
I will speak in Hindi and he will translate. It will be better, more better. If I am speaking in English, I cannot express my ideas fully. So I will speak something in Hindi and he will translate. Because time is also over. It is going 12:30. So I will try to speak very briefly. आज हम लोगों का परम सौभाग्य है कि परम पूज्यपाद नित्य लीला प्रविष्ट ओम विष्णु पार श्रीमद भक्ति रक्षक श्रीधर महाराज जी का आज आविर्भाव तिथि है। यह बात ठीक है, इट इज ट्रू, बात ठीक है। वैष्णव रचिनीते नारे देवेर शक्ति, वैष्णवों को देवता लोग भी नहीं समझ पाते हैं, मनुष्यों की तो बात क्या। बात ठीक, किंतु हम लोगों ने अपने गुरुदेव जी से और दूसरे वैष्णवों के हमने उनके समय में संबंध में हमने कुछ सुना है, आप लोगों के सामने उसको हम उपस्थित कर रहे हैं। वी कैनॉट नो द स्टैंडर्ड ऑफ वैष्णवास हु आर सो मच हाई, बट वी हैव हर्ड समथिंग अबाउट हिम फ्रॉम अवर गुरुदेव, सो आई मस्ट बिलीव ऑन हिम व्हाट ही हैज टोल्ड। हमको गुरु जी के वचनों में विश्वास है, इसलिए मैं आप लोगों के सामने कुछ कह रहा हूँ। पूज्य पाद श्रीधर महाराज जी बहुत ही युवावस्था में, जबकि वो कानून पढ़ रहे थे लॉ, तो एक समय में नवदीप धाम में वे केवल दर्शन करने के लिए वहां उपस्थित हुए और किसी प्रकार से प्रभुपाद से भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी से उनकी भेंट हुई और उनके उपदेशों से इतने प्रभावित हुए कि सब कुछ छोड़ छाड़ कर, उन्होंने विवाह भी नहीं किया था और अपनी पढ़ाई छोड़ करके घर बार सब छोड़ करके ब्राह्मण कुल में जन्मे भी थे, सब कुछ कुछ छोड़ छाड़ करके प्रभुपाद जी के चरणों में उपस्थित होकर के उनकी सेवा में नियुक्त हुए। बोल दिए केवल
Maharaj is saying that of course it is very, very difficult to understand the behavior of Vaishnava. Even demigods are unable to understand. So what to speak of we people? But I will speak something which I have gathered from my own Guru Maharaj and what he has spoken about it, so that I am going to present to you. Maharaj said that once upon a time, when Pujipal Sridhara Maharaj, he was studying law, he came to Navdeep to see Srila Prabhupada. And when he met Srila Prabhupada, and Prabhupada gave him some instruction, and after listening to those instructions, he was so highly impressed and influenced that he at once gave up his house, his study, and totally surrendered to Srila Prabhupada.
इसके बाद में पीछे से उन्होंने संन्यास ग्रहण किया। गुरुजी उनके संबंध में कहा करते थे, ये बड़े विद्वान आदमी थे। हमारे गौड़ीय वैष्णवों के विचारों में बहुत ही निपुण थे, संस्कृत के भी बड़े विद्वान, वे लिखना और पढ़ना भी संस्कृत में करते थे। सुंदर सुंदर आर्टिकल वो लिखा करते और सुंदर सुंदर पंक्तियों की भी रचना करते थे, जिसको देख करके भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती जी बड़े प्रसन्न होते थे।
महाराज इज सेइंग दैट ही हैज हर्ड फ्रॉम हिज गुरु महाराज दैट पूज्यपाद श्रीधर महाराज वाज वेरी मच लर्नड, ही वाज expert in Gaudiya philosophy and a scholar of Sanskrit also. He was adept and expert in delivering Sanskrit shlokas, and such a nice and beautiful shlokas he used to print and make that Sri Prabhupada used to get pleased very much.
मैं तो एक उनके प्रभुपाद जी के संबंध के संबंध में उनकी जो दो एक बातें हैं, मैं आप लोगों को संक्षेप में दो एक बातें सुनाता हूँ जो गुरु जी से मैंने सुना। कि एक समय प्रभुपाद जी के अंतिम समय में जितने भी सन्यासी प्रचारक थे, उन लोगों ने प्रचार करना छोड़ दिया। वो लोग आश्रम में बैठ करके रहने लगे, कोई भी प्रचार न करते और न तो भिक्षा इत्यादि ही करते। इसका कारण यह था, उस समय श्रील प्रभुपाद के सेक्रेटरी परम पूज्यपाद श्री कुंज बिहारी विद्याभूषण जी थे। इन लोगों के मन में ऐसी भावना हुई कि जो हम लोग भिक्षा करके इनको देते हैं, कुंज बिहारी विद्याभूषण को, ये सारे रुपये अपने घर में भेज देते हैं और अपने कुटुंबियों में की सेवा करते हैं उसके द्वारा। इसलिए सभी लोग अप्रसन्न होकर के प्रचार करना बंद कर दिया और पैसे इत्यादि जो भिक्षा करके आता वो भी बंद कर दिया, और इनको एक पैसा भी देने के लिए मना कर दिया। जो हम लोग प्रचार करके इनको कुछ भी नहीं देंगे, देंगे तो प्रभुपाद के हाथ में देंगे। उस समय में श्रील प्रभुपाद जी एक दिन कलकत्ते मठ में, क्या नाम,
बाग बाजार
गौड़ीय मठ में बरांडे में टहल रहे थे और हरिनाम कर रहे थे गंभीर होकर। सब लोगों ने मिलकर के पूज्यपाद सिद्धर महाराज जी को उनके पास में भेजा और कहा जी हम लोग कुंज बिहारी विद्याभूषण को एक पैसा भी भिक्षा का नहीं देंगे और हम प्रचार नहीं करेंगे। यदि प्रभुपाद जी अपने हाथों से लेंगे तब उनको हम अपने हाथों में देंगे और प्रचार करेंगे। जिस समय पूज्यपाद श्रीधर महाराज जी प्रभुपाद जी से इस बात को टहलते हुए कहा, तो प्रभुपाद जी बड़े गंभीर होकर के खड़े हो गए और बोले, इन सब लोगों का सिर कपाल पुड़े छे माने इन लोगों की विचार बुद्धि भ्रष्ट हो गई है, इन लोगों में परमार्थ चिंतन की कोई बुद्धि नहीं रही, और आपका भी ये सिर जल गया, आपकी बुद्धि भी भ्रष्ट हो गई। आप लोग रुपये पैसे देखने के लिए और करने के लिए आए हैं या भगवत भजन करने के लिए आए हैं? यदि मैं अपना अकाउंट कुछ रखने के लिए उसको कुछ पैसे देता हूँ, मान लिया कि कुछ उसको हम महीने में ही 10,000 रुपये दे रहे हैं और वो सब काम कर रहे हैं संसारी, तो तुम्हारा इसमें क्या हानि है? तुम भजन करने के लिए आओ, भजन क्यों नहीं करते? तुमको भी पैसे चाहिए तो तुम्हारे लिए हम व्यवस्था कर दूँ, आपको भी चाहिए। बस श्रीधर महाराज जी का सिर नीचा हो गया। अच्छा ठीक, हमारा विचार गलत है, इन लोगों का विचार गलत है। तो ये बात, ये विचार श्रीधर महाराज जी अपने मुख से कह रहे हैं। हम लोग गए थे उनके पास में तो वो कह रहे थे कि ऐसा उन्होंने कहा था, और तब से हमारा एकदम विचार बदल गया। तो हम लोग कोई भी सांसारिक पदार्थों के लिए संसार में नहीं आए हैं, रुपये पैसे के लिए नहीं आए हैं, इज्जत के लिए नहीं आए हैं, हम अपने गुरु और भगवान की सेवा करने के लिए आए हैं। इसलिए दूसरे मर रहे हैं तो उसको हमको देखने की अधिक जरूरत नहीं है, इसलिए हम भी मर जाएंगे, ये हम लोगों के लिए उचित नहीं है।
महाराज इज नरेटिंग एन इंस्टेंस व्हिच ही हैज हर्ड फ्रॉम हिज गुरु महाराज एज वेल एज ही हैड फ्रॉम पूज्यपाद श्रीधर महाराज आल्सो। He said once upon a time, during the last time of Srila Prabhupada, all the preacher of Srila Prabhupada and sannyasis stopped doing preaching and even collection. The reason is that they were thinking that the secretary of Srila Prabhupada, who was collecting the, who was taking all the collections of preachers, was misusing the money, and he was sending it to his family. His name was Kunji Vihari Vidyabhushan. So they are against him. Once upon a time, Srila Prabhupada was walking in his mat in Calcutta, Bagh Bazar mat, and at that time, all disciples of Srila Prabhupada, making Pujipad Sridhar Maharaj as their representative, sent that he should explain this problem to Srila Prabhupada. When he went to Srila Prabhupada and said, Prabhupada, that we will collect money but will give it to you, not to your secretary, because he is probably misappropriating it. At that time, Srila Prabhupada said, it appears that each of my disciples has become crazy and...
He became so grave.
Yeah, he became grave. He became grave, and at that time he said that each of my disciples has gone out of his head. They don't understand that they have come here for spiritual progress, not for monetary progress. They are estimating the things from monetary point of view. If they are collecting and giving this money to Kunj Bihari, and Kunj Bihari is using some money, I am giving him something, suppose. If I employ a person and give a salary, what is harm in it? They should not think what is happening to this money. They should concentrate that they are here in order for spiritual progress. They should not count the thing of money coming and going. And Maharaj is saying that he has heard this thing from Pujipad Sridhar Maharaj. He said, after narrating this instance, that his view about the spiritual life was totally changed from that day.
Hamare Guru Maharaj ji कहते थे, पूज्यपाद श्रीधर महाराज बहुत ही दार्शनिक विद्वान थे, हमारे गुरुजी भी बड़े दार्शनिक विद्वान थे, यह बात हमारे गौड़ीय मठ के सभी लोग स्वीकार करते हैं। विशेष करके हमारे गुरुजी को हमारे परम गुरुदेव श्री भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर जी ने वेदांत की सारी पुस्तकें उनको दी थी। उन्होंने कहा था कि हमारी पुस्तकों को और दूसरा कोई नहीं देखेगा, तुम इसको देखो पढ़ो। तो गुरुजी महाराज कहा करते थे, कभी कभी हम दोनों में डिस्कशन होता था, कभी कभी हम दोनों में धार्मिक और दार्शनिक विषयों में विचार परामर्श होता था, मैं उनके सारे विचारों को खंडन कर देता और इसके बाद में जब उनकी बारी आती तो वो हमारे सारे विचारों का खंडन करके अपने विचारों की स्थापना कर देते, और इसके बाद तुरंत मैं उनके विचारों के नए नए विचारों का मैं खंडन करके मैं फिर अपने विचारों की स्थापना करता। इस प्रकार से घंटों इसी प्रकार का चलता, और गौड़ीय मठ के जितने भी अच्छे अच्छे सब तत्व को समझने वाले होते थे वैष्णव लोग, सब चारों तरफ से बैठ करके और बड़ा प्रसन्न होकर के इनका डिस्कशन श्रवण करते थे।
महाराज जी सेइंग दैट इज गुरु जी यूज्ड टू से दैट पूज्य श्रीधर महाराज वाज वेरी मच लर्नड फिलोसोफर इन वेदांत गौड़िया वेदांत, एंड इट इज आल्सो वेल नोन दैट इन गौड़िया समिति परम गुरु जी दैट इज महाराज गुरु महाराज वाज आल्सो वेरी highly advanced philosopher. He was renowned philosopher in Gaudiya Samiti.
Vedanta.
That is why Srila Prabhupada gave all the books pertaining to Vedanta to Bhakti Pragyan Keshwari Maharaj and said that you are the person capable to read all these books. So sometimes it used to happen that there should discussion between Param Guru Maharaj Ji and Sripad Sridhar Maharaj. Param Guru Maharaj Ji used to establish some points and Sridhar Maharaj tried to cancel them, to annul it, refute it. Then when Sridhar Maharaj used to speak something, then Param Guru Maharaj Ji used to refute it. And there used to be a good cross exchange of such siddhants and principles, and all those other god brothers used to listen it, and hours it kept on, and everyone used to enjoy this such type of healthy discussion.
इस तरह से गुरु महाराज जी ने 1941 में गौड़िया वेदांत समिति की स्थापना की, और तब से परम पूज्य सिद्ध महाराज उनके साथ में रह करके एक साथ में प्रचार करते और एक जगह रहते थे। इसके बाद में 1942 में हम लोग के गुरु जी ने कठवा में परम पूज्य सिद्ध महाराज जी से संन्यास ग्रहण किया।
परम गुरु महाराज जी एस्टेब्लिश गौड़िया वेदांत समिति इन 1941 and started preaching. At that time Pujpai Sridhar Maharaj was all the time with him and they both were preaching together. Then in 1942 Param Guru Maharaj accepted sannyas order from Sridhar Maharaj.
He also established Gaudiya Vedanta Samiti in 1941 and from then he used to live with our Guruji in Gaudiya Vedanta Samiti. For so many hours, I don't know how many years he was with him, but he was about 44, till 44, he was with our Gurudev. इसके बाद में उन्होंने गुरु जी से कहा कि मैं एकांत स्थान में निर्जन में भजन करना चाहता हूँ, इसलिए आप लोगों का हम लोगों में से वो पास ही में कुछ जमीन है, हमें वो दे दें, छोड़ दें, मैं वहीं पर रह करके भजन निर्जन कुटीर में भजन किया करूँगा। गुरु महाराज ने उनकी बात मान करके और उस जमीन को उनके लिए छोड़ दिया और वहाँ पर रह करके क्या उन्होंने समिति किया, सारस्वत गौड़ीय मठ की वहाँ पर स्थापना करके और वहीं पर रहने लग गए, पीछे से नवद्वीप में ही, और फिर से कुछ शिष्यों को उन्होंने ग्रहण करके और कुछ अपना अलग से साधारण रूप में प्रचार इत्यादि भी करने लग गए।
तो महाराज इज सेइंग दैट हिज गुरु महाराज एंड सीता महाराज वाज लिविंग टुगेदर फॉर मेनी इयर्स प्रोबेबली अप टू 1944 एंड ऑल। देन सीता महाराज सेड दैट नाउ आई वांट टू डू भजन इन आइसोलेशन एंड वांट टू गेट एब्जॉर्ब्ड इनटू इट, you kindly arrange some land for me. So Param Guru Maharaj Ji arranged a land for him in Navdeep, And there, Pujpai Sridhara Maharaj established a mat, Saraswat Gauriya mat. And he was staying over there, and on very low line, he did some preaching work also and accepted a few disciples. But he mostly stayed there, remained there, and his preaching activity remained on very low line.
जितने भी गौड़ीय वैष्णव थे उस समय सभी लोग उनके पास में जाते, जितने भी प्राचीन वैष्णव लोग थे, और सबको वो पारमार्थिक परामर्श देते थे। हमारे गुरु महाराज जी भी संन्यास ग्रहण करने के पश्चात प्रतिवर्ष नवद्वीप परिक्रमा के बाद उनसे जरूर मिलने के लिए जाते थे। और सिद्धा महाराज, पूज्यपाद सिद्धा महाराज भी ऐसा करते थे, हमारे गुरु जी को बहुत ही आदर करते थे और आदर के दृष्टि से कहते थे। संन्यास देने पर भी उनके प्रति ये भावना रहती थी कि हमारे ये सीनियर हैं, और इस दृष्टि से उनको सम्मान देते, और गुरु महाराज जी उनको संन्यास गुरु के रूप में सम्मान देते थे। इस प्रकार से दोनों वैष्णव परस्पर दोनों को ही सम्मान देते थे। वह देखने लायक बात थी।
Interesting thing Maharaj is explaining right now. Maharaj is saying that when he is situated himself there in Saraswat Gauriya Mat, at that time mostly all the Gauriya sannyasis and Vaishnava used to go to him for his spiritual consultation, and he was a spiritual consultant for all of them. And even Maharaj Guru Maharaj also used to go to him at least once in a year after Gaur Purnima Parikrama. And Maharaj is saying that Sridhara Maharaj also used to respect him very much. Param Guru Maharaj used to respect him because he was his sannyas guru. And Pujipa Sridhara Maharaj used to respect him as his senior.
Senior and also most dear friend, servant of Bhakti Siddhant Saraswati Thakur.
And also because that he was very much intimate servant of Srila Prabhupada. From Guru Maharaj, he was really intimate servant of Srila Prabhupada. So Maharaj was saying it was interesting scene to see how two Vaishnavas were respecting and offering their respect and sincere respect to each other.
उनके संबंध में कहना तो बहुत था, किंतु अब एक बजने जा रहा है। यदि समय होगा तो हम शाम को कुछ आप लोगों के सामने उपस्थित करूँगा। केवल यही थोड़ा सा मैं बतलाना चाहता हूँ। इतने सुंदर वो राइटर थे, लेखक थे, और कवि, जन्मजात कवि थे,
इन बर्न पॉइंट
थे वो। सुजनार बुदरादित पाद युगम युग धर्म धुरंधर पात्र परम वरदा भयदायक पूज्य पदम प्रणमामि सदा प्रभुपाद। एंड व्हेन प्रभुपाद सॉ इट ही वाज मेल्टेड, and so that, oh, it is so good. And from then, उसी समय से ही गौड़ीय मठों में सर्वत्र ही इसका प्रतिदिन कीर्तन होने लग गया। किसी किसी का तो लिखने के बाद में, उसके मृत्यु के उपरांत अप्रकट हो जाने के बाद में उनकी कविताएं चलती हैं या ये सब कीर्तन होता है, किंतु उनके जीवित रहते के समय में, और ये उसी समय से जब से लिखा उसी समय में समस्त गौड़ीय मठों में इसका कीर्तन होना आरंभ कर दिया।
महाराज इज सेइंग दैट इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू कैरी ऑन विद ऑल दिस ग्लोरिफिकेशन इन सच अ लिमिटेड टाइम, इट इज अबाउट 1 PM, बट ही वाज, इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू लीव टू मेंशन दैट ही वाज रियली वेरी वेरी स्वीट पोएट। जनरली इट हैपेंस दैट आर्टिस्ट अर्न नेम एंड फेम आफ्टर हिज डेथ, but in this case Pujpa Sridhara Maharaj was such a nice poet, he written Sri Prabhupada's glorification poem which we always recite here, and when he showed to Sri Prabhupada's heart melt and he was so much moved. And since then in his lifetime it was instructed that in all the Gauriya Math temples this poem has to be recited.
और भी एक उन्होंने लिखा बहुत ही सुंदर सरस कविता, प्रेमधाम स्तोत्रम। प्रेमधाम देवमेव Naomi Gaura Sundaram. Also so many things he has written. I know that I have never heard anything about Gayatri from any other. But from him, I saw this year, when I was explaining the meaning of Gayatri. Gayatri is himself Shabda Brahma. But I was giving some outline. And at once I saw a booklet. And in that, I saw that Bhargava Devasya Dhimahi Dhiyo Yo Naha Prachodayat. Very wonderful. He has given the meaning of this two words. All words he has explained. But I moved and charmed by this. I used to explain, but I could not have given seen any reference to justify my explanation. But now I had some good proof of that. And I became so happy. So, Bharga Devasya, Bharga means Tej. Tej means Shakti. Shakti means power. I am meditating the power of Krishna, that is Srimati Radhika. So, Bharga Devasya, Shakti, Tej of Krishna. And she should calm in my heart. So he has written so many things, 10 or so many slokes about this, explaining each word of Brahma Gayatri. So marvelous and wonderful. Also, I used to go, after my Gurudev, I also used to go sometimes with any brahmachari to him. Once in Harikatha, एक समय हरि कथा में हमसे उनसे बात होने लगी, बधि मार्ग और रागा मार्ग के संबंध में बातचीत हुई। हमारे प्रश्नोत्तरों को सुनकर के बड़े प्रसन्न हुए। मैं अपने गुरुजी से भी प्रश्न और प्रश्न करता था। मैं चुपचाप बैठने वाला नहीं, कुछ भी आता उनसे प्रश्न करता, जिसको कहते हैं मुंह लग गया। वैसे पूज्यपाद श्रीधर महाराज जी को भी मैं जाने पर जरूर कुछ न कुछ जरूर प्रश्न करता था। तो मैंने किसी प्रकार से प्रसंग वर्षत वैधि और रागानुमार्ग के संबंध में उनसे कोई प्रश्न पूछा, तो उन्होंने ये बतलाया, एक संक्षेप में बतलाया, मातिलो गौरजन कीर्तन रंगे, मातिलो गौरजन कीर्तन रंगे, पूजल राग पथ गौरव भंगे। गौरव भंगे मीन्स चैतन्य महाप्रभु के जितने भी प्रकार हैं, गौर कीर्तन में एकदम प्रमत्त हो गए। किंतु उसमें एक विशेषता थी, विशेषता ये थी, चैतन्य महाप्रभु बहिरंग संगे करे नाम संकीर्तन और अंतरंग लैया करे रसास्वादन। बहिरंग भक्तों के साथ में वो कीर्तन करते थे और सबको कीर्तन रंग में मता देते थे। और विशेष रस के 3.5 जन स्वरूप दामोदर राय रामानंद सिखी मैत्री हिज सिस्टर माधवी ऑफ 84 ईयर्स एज एंड लाइक दिस, इस तरह के लोगों को लेकर के अंतरंग लैया करे रसास्वादन, उनका रसास्वादन करते थे। तो ये कह रहे हैं पूजिल राग पथ, दोनों में अंतर है। कोई जरूरी नहीं है कि हजारों वर्ष तक वैदिक भक्ति करने से रागानुगा आ ही जाएगा, कोई जरूरी नहीं। यदि वैष्णवों का, शुद्ध वैष्णवों का रसिक और भाव भक्तों का, श्रीमद् भागवत का रसिक, यदि व्याख्या यदि वो सुने उनके मुख से, या भागवत पढ़ो वैष्णव स्थान है, तो उनके मुख से सुन करके हो सकता है कि कोटि कोटि लोगों में से किसी एक व्यक्ति को लोभ उत्पन्न हो ब्रज की सेवा के लिए। जिस समय होगा उस समय क्या होगा, पूजिल राग पथ गौरव भंगे, गौरव उसका छूट जाएगा, गौरव भाव भगवान का ऐश्वर्य इत्यादि भाव दूर हो जाएगा और उस समय में यह राग पथ कि में वो प्रवेश कर सकता है। बहुत सी बातें बतलाएं किंतु हमारे दिमाग में उस समय ये सब नहीं आया क्योंकि मैं बहुत ही निम्न कोटि का था। इस तरह से उनके इन सब विचारों को हमने देखा है, सुना है। मैं नहीं कह सकता देख कितने बड़े ऊंचे थे, उन लोगों के सामने में हम लोगों ने संन्यास लिया है किंतु एरंडम द्रुमायते, पाले पाले बड़े बड़े वृक्षों में हम लोग बहुत छोटे छोटे घास के समान हैं। जब उनका हम यह ज्ञान वैराग्य और भक्ति देखते हैं तो हम लोगों का लगता है कि हम लोग सन्यासी या वैष्णव ही नहीं हैं उनके सामने। आज हम बड़े प्रीति के साथ में अपने हृदय की सारी भावनाओं को लेकर आज अपने परम गुरुदेव के समान परम पूज्य पाद सिद्धार्थ गोस्वामी महाराज जी के चरणों में मैं अपने हृदय की प्रेम पुष्पांजलि अर्पित करता हूँ। वे ग्रहण कर एक परम गुरुदेव, मैंने हमारे परम गुरुदेव शिक्षा हमारे गुरुजी और उनके संन्यास गुरु एक तरह से परम गुरुदेव है, इसलिए मैंने कहा।
In English there is a phrase, all great men think alike. I may say all Vaishnava also have, they think alike. Maharaji has been explaining us from Gayatri so many times and explaining Bhargava Devasya Dhimahi. And he was saying the same explanation he found was being done by Pujpa Sridhara Maharaj. He was doing of his own and he was doing of his own, but both were the same because all Vaishnavas think alike. So then Maharaj said that he went to Sripad Sridhara Maharaj after disappearance of his Gurudev, sometimes with his some brahmacharis, along with some brahmacharis. Maharaj said that he was not a quiet type of personality. Whenever he will go to anyone, he will have question answers. And he will not let him sit silent. To his own Guru Maharaj, he used to keep on asking so many questions. And similarly, when he used to go to Sridhara Maharaj, he asked a few questions. One time he asked a question about Vedimarg and Ragmarg. Then he gave an answer, very beautiful answer in a small line. It's never so that if you keep on doing Vedi Bhakti for years together, it will convert into Raganuga. It is not possible like that. If in between someone meets some Rasik Vaishnava, really, who is deep into Braj Bhav, then only he can get it. If he gets this Raganuga Bhav, what happens then? He was quoting, Ujila Ragpat Gaurava Bhange. When he enters into this path of rag, which is ujila, means glorified mark, this rag mark. At that time, our opulent thinking about Lord, Gaurav thinking about Lord, our reverence and opulent thinking about Krishna, that goes down. So, Maharaj says that he is such an advanced devotee in the capacity of Param Guru Maharaj. I offer my heartily Pushpanjali to him and my all bhav to him also.
Now we are going to worship him and we will go give our Pushpanjali to him, and after that in the meantime we will see Aarti here and then we will discuss our this. यदि कोई लोग आप लोग कुछ दक्षिणा देना चाहते हैं, if you want to give anything, especially donation, you can give. Please request. Now we should go and sing Sri Guru Charana Padma or any song.